And welcome to our channel. My name is Dmitry, and I'm a part of the Exactpro research team. At Exactpro, we build software to test software. Please check out our website for more information about us. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell button to make sure that you see the upcoming videos. We are continuing a series based on ISTQB Certified Tester AI Testing Syllabus. Today, we'll go over Chapter 5 called Machine Learning Functional Performance Metrics. And we will also discuss that one of the key steps in developing machine learning models is assessing the quality of the model. When it comes to classification problems, a model will rarely give us correct predictions every single time. In order to understand this a little bit better, we need to create a confusion matrix or error matrix with the following outcomes. As you can see from this table, true positive is the number of objects that the model has assigned to a given class, and they truly belong to that class. For example, the model predicts that the text is a bug description, and it really is a bug description. True negative is the number of objects the model has not assigned to that class, and they are indeed not in that class. That is, the model says that the text is not a bug description, and it's really not a bug description. False negative is the number of objects that the model does not assign to the class, but they do, in fact, belong to it. For example, the model predicts that the text is not a bug description, but in fact, it is a bug description. And the last one is false positive. This is the number of objects the model assigns to a given class, but in fact, they do not belong to it. That is, the model says the text is a bug description, but in fact, it is not. Based on the confusion matrix, we can define the following metrics. The first metric is accuracy. Accuracy is the probability that the class will be predicted correctly. We take the number of all correct predictions, true positive and true negative, and divide it by the total number of predictions. The next metric is precision. Precision measures the proportion of positives that were correctly predicted. It is a measure of how sure one can be about positive predictions. We do this by dividing the number of items correctly predicted by the total number of items attributed to the class. The third metric is called recall. Recall, also known as sensitivity, measures the proportion of actual positives that were predicted correctly. It is a measure of how sure one can be about not missing any positives. And the last one is F1 score, which is the harmonic mean of precision and recall. The result is a value between 0 and 1. A score close to 1 indicates that the false data has little influence on the result, and the low F1 score suggests that the model is poor at detecting positives. There are numerous other metrics for different types of machine learning problems. Some of the most commonly used metrics are: the receiver operating characteristic curve is a graphical plot that illustrates the dependence of the correct positive classification proportion on the false positive classification proportion when varying the threshold of the decisive rule. The ROC curve is plotted with true positive rate, TPR also known as recall, against the false positive rate, FPR, with TPR on the y-axis and FPR on the x-axis. The area under the curve represents the degree of a classifier separability, showing how well the model distinguishes between classes. The higher the AUC, the better the model predictions. For supervised regression models, the metrics represent how well the regression line fits the actual data points. Here we have mean square error. MSE is the average of the square differences between the actual value and the predicted value. The value of MSE is always positive, and a value closer to zero suggests a better regression model. By squaring the difference, it ensures positive and negative errors do not cancel each other out. R-squared, also known as determination coefficient, is a measure of how well the regression model fits the dependent variables. For unsupervised clustering, there are several metrics that represent the distances between the various clusters and the closeness of data points within a given cluster. Intra-cluster metrics measure the similarity of data points within a cluster. Intra-cluster metrics measure the similarity of data points in different clusters. The silhouette coefficient, also known as silhouette score, is a measure between -1 and +1, based on the average intercluster and intracluster distances. A score of +1 means the clusters are well separated, and a score of 0 implies random clustering, and a score of -1 means that the clusters are wrongly assigned. Machine learning functional performance metrics are limited to measuring the functionality of the model. For example, in terms of accuracy, precision, recall, MSE, AUC, and the silhouette coefficient. They do not measure other non-functional quality characteristics, such as performance efficiency or explainability, flexibility, and autonomy. Machine learning functional performance metrics can also be constrained by several other factors, like labeling accuracy, data representativeness, absence of support tools, and the fact that there could be several components in the system where these apply to the machine learning model only. Building a machine learning model that achieves the highest score for all of the machine learning functional performance metrics generated from the confusion matrix is very difficult. To make it easier, the most appropriate functional performance metrics are selected as acceptance criteria, based on the expected use of the model. For example, to minimize false positives, a high value of precision is required, whereas to minimize false negatives, the recall metrics should be high. The following criteria can be used when selecting the machine learning functional performance metrics. Accuracy can be applicable if the false positive and false negative counts and costs are similar. But if one class of data dominates over others, then we should consider the F1 score. Precision can be suitable when the cost of false positives is high and the confidence in positive outcomes needs to be high. But when the classifier deals with situations where a very large percentage of cases are positive, then using precision alone is unlikely to be a good choice. Recall is critical for positives not to be missed. And for this, a high recall score is important. For example, missing any true positive results in cancer detection and marking them as negative is unacceptable. F1 score is most useful when there is an imbalance in the expected classes and when the precision and recall are of similar importance. In addition, several metrics may be applicable for given machine learning problems as well. The AUC for the ROC curve may be used for supervised classification problems. MSE and R-squared may be used for supervised regression problems. Intra-cluster metrics and the silhouette coefficient may be used for unsupervised clustering problems. New AI technologies get released regularly, thus making it difficult to determine their efficacy. In order to objectively compare these technologies, we have industry-standard machine learning benchmark suites. They cover a wide range of application areas and provide tools to evaluate hardware and software frameworks and cloud platforms. Machine learning benchmark suites can provide various measures, including training and inference times. Machine learning benchmark suites are provided by different organizations, such as ML Commons, Don Bench, and MLMark. And that is it for video number 5. If you liked it, give us a thumbs up. In the next one, we will be talking about Chapter 6, titled Machine Learning, Neural Networks and Testing. As always, let me remind you that we do have a ton more awesome videos on our channel. So, feel free to subscribe and hit that bell button. Thanks for watching and see you soon.